This week on Vintage.
The winner of the 1993 Battle Bowl.
Hello, WWE Universe. Welcome to WWE Vintage. I am Renee Young. Tis the season where everyone's sitting on the edge of their seats, cheering on their favorite team, who will be facing each other by random selection, all in pursuit of one trophy. Yes, I am talking bowl season. Battle Bowl, that is. You probably thought I was talking about football. Not the case. The WCW, they actually had their own tournament in the 90s, which was commonly known as Battle Bowl. What's Battle Bowl, you ask? Well, the concept was simple, even if the results weren't. Names of several WCW superstars would be placed into a lottery of sorts where they would be selected at random to form pairs of tag teams. Sometimes the teams formed cohesive units. Other times, many WCW superstars were forced to work with their mortal enemies. Nonetheless, each team had one mission: to win their tag team match and advance to the night's grand finale, the Battle Bowl Battle Royal, in search of being the last man standing and winning the Battle Bowl ring. Battle Bowl was so successful in WCW that it actually received its own telecast in 1993, which is where we're going to take you next. Now, you're actually probably wondering where Gene is today, but someone's got to pick the names, right? So let's send it down to Pensacola, Florida, where Gene is standing by with Ric Flair's maid, Fifi, and I'm hearing that they're going to be picking the names for our first round. Gene?
Fifi, it's going to be a little different tonight. You and I are going to have a lot of fun. Just a second there. Fifi, let's draw the first couple of names for this time. Let's roll this barrel one more time. The way these names come out is the way these guys head to the ring. So let's bring them around. You do the drawings, and I'll mention the names. The name of Cactus Jack. I can hardly wait to see who this next one will be. Oh, my God. WCW Heavyweight Champion Vader.
My goodness. Can you believe that? It's Cactus Jack and Vader right out of the box. I mean, our last pay-per-view, they were beating each other to death, Jesse.
Well, we'll find out if they're professionals or not, Tony Schiavone.
Their opposing tag team. One of the members will be from Harlem Heat, Cole.
It's Cole of Harlem Heat.
Hey, you go get him, baby. Go get that sucker.
Thankfully, Gene was able to stay focused long enough to pick our first duo. However, let's assess the story behind this monumental pairing with the Battle Bowl breakdown. For the majority of 1993, Cactus Jack, Mick Foley's most intense alter ego, was engaged in a rivalry with the WCW World Champion Vader. This included Vader powerbombing Jack on exposed concrete and rendering Jack with amnesia. While Cactus certainly didn't forget the animosity between himself and Vader, as this unlikely duo prepares to take on Cole and Charlie Norris. Now, don't worry if Norris doesn't sound too familiar, but shame on you if you can't tell that Cole would go on to be better known as Harlem Heat's very own Stevie Ray. Which team would make the most of this random selection to pick up a victory?
Cactus Jack in there, now Vader on one side, and once again, as we said, they got to put their differences behind them. Let's see what happens here.
Well, they don't necessarily have to. They simply got to win. And now you see Vader going after Cole of Harlem Heat.
And Cactus goes after Vader.
And Race is caught in the middle.
Harley Race wants to make this a team. Vader is the man, the WCW World Heavyweight Champion. After Charlie Norris. Charlie, really the youngster in this, the rookie. Norris is prone on the mat.
Oh. And Vader caught him. Is he going to go for a pin? No. there, Tony.
Jesse, in seeing Vader hold the man that time, Charlie Norris and Cactus Jack come off, who would have thought back on the 24th of October we'd be seeing these two men together? Mike, what powerbomb time, Jess?
Whoa! And so much momentum, Vader went over backwards. Cover! He got him! Vader and Cactus advance.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the first tag team attraction, the team of Cactus Jack and WCW Heavyweight Champion, Vader!
Big power bomb, and the world champion, Vader, gets up slowly, and he and Cactus Jack are still in the ring together. This was a wild way to begin our Battle Bowl pay-per-view. A good look at Cactus. One half of the World Tag Team Champions, Brian Knobbs of the Nasty Boys, along with Johnny B. Badd. Very interesting team of Paul Roma and Eric Watts on the other side. Good leapfrog. Look at that timing by Paul Roma. Great anticipation, but down he goes from an arm drag. Say what you want about this team of Johnny B. Badd and Knobbs, but they complement each other's style quite well. Great competition here in our third annual Battle Bowl. Flying body press. Now throws him up. He's got the tights. Johnny B. Badd shaking his head. He did not like the way his team won it.
Welcome back to this Battle Bowl edition of Vintage. With two less than united teams already advancing, it's time to send it back down to Gene and Fifi with our next selections.
Gene,
you're on the air.
Gene, you lecherous old fool.
Don't blow on it. That's just an expression. Hold on, wait a minute.
Apparently we're on the air. Let's get back to business here. Oh, my word. That's good enough. Let's see what we draw this time. Fifi and myself hard at work with this drum. All right. See whose name this is. The Shockmaster. Wow. I said, what do you think of that, Fifi? What do you think of me, Fifi? Tisk, tisk. Wow. Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Well, that's a story in itself.
Let's see who their opponents will be. All right, the name of Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Excuse me there, sweetheart.
Ricky Steamboat, the Dragon.
Let's see who Steamboat's partner will be.
Former television champion.
Here is part of the Lethal Lottery. Wow. Lord Steven Regal.
Whoa! Hey!
I don't know about that. I really don't know. Guys better get ready for World War III down there.
Time to break it down. Let's examine our next two teams. After having perhaps the most infamously memorable debut in sports entertainment history, the Shockmaster tried to turn his luck around, and perhaps a Battle Bowl ring would do it. Well, thanks to the Lethal Lottery, he would have the help of a WrestleMania 1 main eventer and Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. But then again, Orndorff wasn't looking out for anybody but himself. Yet Orndorff had recent history with his opponent, particularly with Ricky Steamboat, over the WCW television title. While the Dragon would defeat Orndorff for this title, Steamboat would go on to lose it to who else? His Battle Bowl partner, Lord Steven Regal.
Full Nelson.
And there's the scientific way out of a full Nelson. Grabs the ankle off the rope. Nice cartwheel by Lord Steven. And look at that. Mr. Wonderful appreciates it. He says, hey, what a move. And look at Steamboat griping again. How does Lord Steven put up with him?
There's no question that the team, so far of all the teams we've seen, this team has...
Look at it, and Steamboat wants to hog the spotlight. He slaps Lord Steven and replaces him. What an egomaniac Steamboat is.
Well, no, Ricky is nothing of the kind. Into the ropes now. Steamboat up.
Ha ha, he got caught. Oh, and wonderful. I'll bet he wishes he could tag out now. I'll bet he wishes he was back on the apron and it was Lord Steven in there, huh? Now, what a nice guy. Look at the position he gives the Shockmaster. Will the Shockmaster follow up? Yeah, and he misses.
Yeah, there was too much time wasted right there, Jeff, between tags. Oh, look, now, wait a second. The old short arm tag here. Steamboat reached down, he pulled the arm back. And the Shockmaster made sure the tag was made. Shockmaster and the television champion, Lord Steven Regal, going out at the big guy. Oh, the big guy missed. One, two.
Whoa! Lord Steven rolled out of the way and wonderful hit the Shockmaster.
Watch out, watch out. You got tag team partners fighting over the umbrella. Oh, he hit Regal in the head. He hit Regal in the head with the umbrella. And the television champion's down. He's down. Here's the cover. One, two, three. What about that?
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the team of the Shockmaster and Mr. Wonderful.
What a great move by Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, huh?
He took himself out of battle mode, Jeff. Exactly what he did.
What an egomaniac that Steamboat is.
But, Fifi, if you just let me know just that.
What are you
looking at, Mr. G? What was that, Fifi?
What are you looking at?
I saw something here reminded me of melons. I don't know what it was. Let's go. See if we can figure something out here. We got to get... I don't believe there's a telephone here, but if I could get to one, I think I'd call somebody. Let's see who we have here. Boy, I can't believe this action. And in the ring, too, it's pretty good. Can you believe this? Sting!
Former Battle Bowl champion making his way to the ring area now.
His partner, ladies and gentlemen, the Nasty Boy, Sags!
Oh, Sting and Sags!
Here we go with another name. Superstar, All-American Ron Simmons!
All
this
right.
Place is upside down, Pee-Pee. From the Cole brothers, Keith Cole.
Battle Bull had the tendency to break up even the strongest of teams, as it did with the WCW Tag Team Champions, the Nasty Boys. However, Jerry Sags did gain himself one of the strongest competitors in Battle Bull by being paired with the original Battle Bull champion, Sting. While experience was on their side, inexperience plagued their opponents as Keith Cole makes his live event debut picking up WWE Hall of Famer Ron Simmons as his partner. Simmons must be